Hey everybody, it's your personal trainer, Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia, and this is a total body strength training workout.
The only equipment required for this workout is a pair of dumbbells and then either a chair or a bench.
While I'll be providing some modifications for some of the harder movements, this is not a beginner workout. If you are a true beginner, you can go ahead and click the link up top and this will send you over to our beginner strength training routine.
All right, let's get started with a quick warm up. The first thing that we're gonna do doesn't require any equipment. We're gonna do an overhead squat. We're gonna get your heart rate up a little bit and work on our mobility. Feet are shoulder width apart. Let's go and put those arms straight up overhead. Now, anytime we squat, break at the hips first and then bend at the knees. We're trying our best to keep a nice straight line from our fingertips down to our hips. So while performing this, you might be a little bit tight. Totally common, we are too. But as we're going down, we're trying our best to fight that feeling and that urge to bend over this way, right? So instead, keep that back nice and straight. Being sure to breathe. We're just moving at a warm-up pace, trying to loosen up our entire body with this one from our shoulders to our posterior and spine. Let's just hit this one for just 10 more seconds. Nice, keep that back straight, core stays tight, head in a nice neutral position for 3, 2, 1, 0. Excellent, shake those arms loose. We're gonna move into a standing arm hauler. So feet are gonna be shoulder width apart. I want you to go ahead and bend over on a 45 degree angle. Let's go ahead and swim those arms forward with your thumbs down, bring them out to your side, press forward and repeat. So just going through this big swimming motion. And again, on that swim, as you swing those arms, your thumbs are down. Keep your back straight and do your best to go ahead and keep your arms in alignment with your upper body. Weight goes back in your hips. It's a great one just to go ahead and loosen up and warm up those shoulders. We are gonna work them today. Actually hitting just every single muscle group you have in today's workout. Very efficient workout we have in store for you today. Let's go ahead and hit this one for just 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All right, one more in this quick warm up. We're gonna move into a multi-planar lunge. So let's hit the ground. We're gonna get into a high plank position or a push-up position, whichever you prefer to call it. Now let's bring your right foot up outside of your right hand. We're gonna reach through to your left and reach up overhead to your right. Go ahead and repeat this move. Love this one, again, just as a very efficient move. Warms up multiple muscles at the same time. Also a great one for your mid-back thoracic spine mobility. And I find on this one, wherever I'm most sore from maybe my previous workouts is usually where I'm gonna feel it the most. Anywhere from my hamstrings to my back. Breathe, nice and controlled. Again, this is just your warm up. Getting ready for that work that's ready to come. Let's switch sides in 3, 2, 1, 0. Go ahead and step back with that right leg. Step up with the left. And let's begin on the opposite side. I want you to use this warm up as your opportunity to get your head mentally prepared. Think about what brought you here today to begin with. Whatever it is gonna be the same thing that gets you through this workout. Focus on what motivates you, what drives you. Let's do this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Excellent.
Ooh,
all right, stand up, shake it off. I know, always one of my favorites. Okay, so next we're gonna get started with the superset. So we have two different exercises. We're gonna go back and forth. We're gonna do 3 sets of 8 repetitions, right? Yes, 3 sets of 8 repetitions of both of them. The first one is gonna be a split squat plus row. We're gonna need our dumbbells for this one. I'm gonna do a Bulgarian split squat, which means I'm gonna have my 1 foot up on the bench.
And I'm gonna be doing a split squat, which means both of my legs are gonna be on the ground in a split position here.
And actually, we just need the 1 dumbbell for the first one.
Yep.
Feet are shoulder width apart. I'm gonna have my 1 back leg up on the bench. Again, Claudia's just both feet on the ground, but we're gonna drop that back knee till it gets to a 90 degree angle. And as we come up, pull back on that elbow and row. So down and row. We're doing 8 repetitions. Let's hit it together, starting in 3, 2, 1, 0. Keep good posture on this one. Back is straight. Head is in a nice neutral position.
Get your core nice and tight.
Again, dropping down till that back knee reaches a 90 degree angle. You don't want that front knee to come too far over your front foot. Let's hit that last one. Excellent. Okay, switching sides now. Right into it, no rest. Right into that next one. All right, get your balance. I think I got it. All right, let's go. Drop that back knee straight down. And this one definitely requires a little bit more balance. If you're having trouble balancing, find a focal point for your eyes. It'll help you stay balanced. Nice.
Three more.
Pulling back on that elbow every time. Like there's a string attached to that elbow. Last one. All right, nice. Okay, so we do need your second dumbbell for the second exercise in this superset. We are going to do a reverse curl plus shoulder press. So palms are facing us, elbows are in. We're gonna curl and then press overhead and reverse it down. Reverse curl. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's hit it together, 8 reps. Ready, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you'll see as we go through today's workout, it's designed in such a way that while one set of muscles is working, the other is resting. So while we're not gonna take very long breaks in between, for instance, right now our legs are resting and our back is resting while our shoulders and biceps are doing
the
work.
Two more, guys.
You got it, keep it up. Good posture on this one. Slight bend in those knees.
Last one.
All right, very good. Okay, so we're going back to that split squat plus row. You decide which variation is right for you, whether you have your back leg up a little bit harder or both feet on the ground. All right, let's drop that back knee straight down in 3, 2, 1, begin. Down, pull back on that elbow. Excellent work, starting to get a little warm now, feeling good. Breathe. Any of these strength training exercises, you always want to breathe in on the easy part and breathe out, exhale on the hardest part of the move.
Last one right here, guys, and we'll switch sides.
All right.
There you go.
Switch it up and right into it. Like I said, eliminating that downtime. Begin. And if you can't quite go all the way down to that back knee, it's a 90. That's all right. Do the best you can. Come back. Get a little bit better every time. And your flexibility, mobility will improve.
Two more.
Almost there. Good.
Whew.
All right, let's grab that second dumbbell. Moving into that reverse curl plus shoulder press. Let's get those biceps and shoulders real good. All right, elbows are in. And 3, 2, 1, begin. On that reverse curl, I really want you to focus on keeping your wrists nice and tight and straight. Don't use what I like to call spaghetti wrists, right? But instead, keep those forearms engaged. Nice tight grip on those dumbbells.
Halfway point, guys.
All the way up, all the way down. You got it. Beautiful combo move here of hitting your forearms, biceps, shoulders, and triceps. Good, full range.
You have two more.
Almost there. Breathe, last one. Excellent.
Woo, goodness. That's
okay.
A great one.
Just one dumbbell for the next one. We get that last set of the split squat in a row. You got it right here. Right into it, like I said, minimizing that downtime. Good posture. Drop that back knee straight down and begin. 1, 2, good. Drive off that heel, stay nice and balanced. Not allowing that front knee to come too far over your foot. You got it, 1 into the next. Breathe.
Last one right here.
All right, switch it up.
Done with that side.
8 repetitions, here we go. And begin. Nice controlled pace on this one. It is a strength training routine, so not in a big hurry on this one. Good. Stay balanced, find a focal point for those eyes, something to stare at, help you stay balanced.
Last one.
All right, good.
Ooh, no more of those split squats.
All right, check, cross those off the list. Grab that second dumbbell. Reverse curl, shoulder press. Get after it, guys. Here we are. Elbows are in. What'd you come here for today? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Get full range of motion. Nice and controlled on this one. not using a lot of momentum. And if you need to switch up your weight during any point of today's workout, start with the heavier weight and you need to go lighter. Or maybe you started too light, you need to go heavier. Whatever it is, we encourage you to
three
do
more.
So. Make this workout your own. Good, almost there. Let's hit that last one right here. And done, nice. All right, for the next superset, we're gonna go back and forth between a posterior movement and an anterior movement. The first one we're gonna do is gonna be a sumo deadlift, and then we're gonna pause 1/1000, and on the way up, we're gonna pull up on those elbows into an upright row for 3x8. And then we're gonna do a one arm push up. We'll get to that in a second, also for 3x8. Let's grab some dumbbells, two of them, for that sumo deadlift plus upright row. Our feet are a little wider than shoulder width apart. Go ahead and point out on those toes. Dumbbells are facing us. We're gonna break at those hips, butt back. Pause, 1/1000. On the way up, use those arms pulling up from the elbows. Let's begin, 8 reps in 3, 2, 1. Let's hit it. Nice full range of motion. On the way up, pulling up with those elbows. Get a complete stop down there at the bottom. And we're trying to go down to the point where we get those hips parallel to the ground.
Halfway.
Keep your back nice and straight, core tight. Really feel those hips stretching back there. You don't want to be bent over or hunched over on this one. Good. And then you're pulling straight up from those elbows, keeping the dumbbells nice and close to your body.
And almost there. That was there. Your last one, actually.
Oh, that was the last one. I thought
I'm
we had
sorry.
One. That's okay. That was the last one. Well, you're good. Okay, you can set your dumbbells down. We're doing a one-arm push-up. Claudia's going to do it from the wall. It's okay. I'm going to do it from the bench. You can decide which version is right for you. From the bench is definitely more difficult.
Of course, if you're doing it from the wall, the further back your feet are, the harder it is. So you can scoot your feet up a little closer to the wall.
Same thing with the bench. Okay, so one arm, make sure that arm is in that hand is in line with your chest. So you're not stretching your head to the wall or the bench, but instead trying to bring your body close to it. We're doing 8 reps on each side. You decide which variation is right for you. In 3, 2, 1, let's begin. Nice full range of motion. This one is definitely a tough one, not an easy one. Both variations are butt kickers. Now you're starting to see why we said this one is not a beginner routine. Full range of motion.
And you have one more on this side, guys.
Good, all right, switching sides now. Let's hit 8 on that opposite side. 3, 2, 1, begin. Trying to come down until that elbow reaches about a 90 degree angle. Keeping that core tight, back stays straight. You got it, one
three
and
more.
The next. Almost there.
And last one right here, guys.
Finish strong.
Oh my goodness.
All right, those definitely are effective.
Yes.
All right, let's grab those dumbbells. I got that sumo deadlift plus upright row. Feet are pointed out just a little bit. Here we are, right into it. In 3, 2, 1, weight back in the hips. And pull up on those elbows. Coming to that dead stop down there at the bottom. And at the bottom, you should really be emphasizing putting that weight back in your glutes. All about the glutes on this one. Excellent.
Halfway point.
Breathe. And as this workout gets tougher, just gotta keep focusing on that why. What are you here for? What's your goal? What are you trying to achieve? It's not gonna happen overnight.
Last one, guys.
But day after day you put in the work, you can get it. Nice,
ooh,
okay.
My buns are feeling that one.
Yes, we like it. It's working, tribe. It's working, HASfit tribe. All right, here we go. Set up your bench or get over to that wall. Right into it. Try not to kick my wife here.
No, you're good.
All right. And 3, 2, 1, begin. Channeling my inner Rocky over here. Not quite at Sylvester Stallone's level, but we're just trying to get better every day, guys. Not about being perfect, just about putting in that work.
3 more.
Nice, keep it up. Keep grinding, keep fighting.
Last one.
Woo, all right, switch sides now, switch sides, come on. Let's go right into it, 3, 2, 1, begin. Nice. Keep it up. Keep that core tight. Back stays straight. Keep challenging yourself to get that full range of motion.
Halfway point.
Almost there. Keep working.
You have one more, guys.
Last one right here.
Woo, nice work.
Nice. Okay. We got those sumo deadlifts next. No downtime while that chest and shoulders are resting. Now it's on to your legs. All right, let's go. Feet are nice and wide.
This is the last one of these.
Let's hit it and begin. Down, one thousand. Pull, repeat. You got it, guys. What'd you come here for? What's your why? Stay focused on it. Breathe.
Pull on those elbows.
You got it. Putting in the work right here, right now to achieve those goals. Not gonna come to you on accident. Not just gonna wake up one morning and they're there. It's all about that day after day grind. That's what you're doing right here. Keep it up. Breathe.
You guys, you have last one.
Right here. Stay strong. Boom.
Whew.
All right. Here we are. Last set of these one-arm push-ups. These things are kicking my butt. That's all right. That's how I know they're working. In position. And let's begin in 3, 2, 1. Get after it. Nice full range of motion. Stretch that chest. You got it. Stay tough, guys. These are tough, but you're tougher.
Three more.
Almost there. All right, last one.
Woo. Done with that side.
All right.
Home
last
stretch
of these,
on
guys.
These.
You got it. You got it. And begin. This is especially tough after the shoulder workout we did last night. That's all right. We're hurting too, guys. You're not alone. Keep fighting through it. We're right there with you.
You only have two more after this.
Almost there. Finish strong.
Excellent.
Ah, nice job.
All right, so the next superset we're doing is either a clean and reverse lunge or a clean to a front squat, followed by tricep pop-up. So you're gonna need both of your dumbbells for the first one.
We're gonna do 12 repetitions. So it's either 6 on each leg if you're doing the reverse lunge or 12 squats in total. So feet are shoulder width apart. Go ahead and swing those dumbbells back behind you, and as you swing them up, curl up and drop down. They come back down. And then you're gonna drop down. We're doing 12 reps. Let's do it together in 3, 2, 1, begin. Again, you decide which variation is right for you. Either way, we're dropping those hips back, dropping those knees to a 90 degree angle. If you're doing the reverse lunge variation, I want you to try your best not to bounce that back knee off the ground, but instead, you can just go ahead and kiss it or stop right before that knee hits the ground.
And if you're doing my variation, make sure you're keeping those knees out on the front squat and your core nice and tight, guys. You only have two more.
Nice, come on, keep it up. Legs are feeling it. Feels so good.
Last one.
And done, nice, okay. Dropping those dumbbells, we don't need them for the next one. We're gonna go down to the ground into like a high plank position or a push-up position. Claudia's gonna do this one from her knees. I'm gonna do this one from up top on my feet. This is a tough one. I want you to place those hands in front of your face. So they're out, your hands and arms are out in front of you. Now elbows are gonna stay in as you drop those elbows straight down and back up using your triceps. Only 8 repetitions of this one. Let's get it going in 3, 2, 1 and begin. Again, keep those elbows in. Don't allow them to flare out. This one is a great one to isolate those triceps. Try not to let your chest, your shoulders intervene and help out. No shame in dropping to your knees if you have to. This is not an easy move. Keep it up, guys.
Two more.
Almost there. Don't hold your breath.
And this is your last one right there.
Excellent.
Nice job.
All right. I'm gonna up my weight just a little bit on these clean plus reverse lunges. All right, let's get it going. We got 12 reps in 3, 2, 1, swing those dumbbells back and up. Good. And again, while those triceps are resting, our arms, biceps, legs are all working. Breathe. Great total body workout today. No muscles left behind. I think Claudia said that a few weeks ago. It's my new favorite line. I'm gonna steal it from her.
That's fine, you can do that.
Keep breathing, guys, you got it. One rep into the next. Keep fighting, you got it. Remember, those who think they can't and those who think they can are both right.
You have one more.
Which one are you today? Come on, last one. Excellent. Woo. All right, set those
Excellent.
Down. Moving right into those pop-ups.
Let's do it.
A little downtime. Come on up into that high plank position. We got 8 reps in 3, 2, 1, right into it. Control both the descent and the way up at ascent. So we're not just flying down onto our elbows and jumping up, but I really want you to feel that contraction, feel that time under tension of those triceps. Yes, it makes it harder, but it also makes it way more effective. What's the point of working out if it's not gonna work?
You guys, you have one more.
That's it, come on. Boom.
Woo.
Nice. We got one more each of these, come on. Let's go, keep that energy up, guys. Keep that energy up.
All right, I guess I'll push on the last one.
Don't hit that pause button. Just keep moving, right here with you. Swing those dumbbells back in 3, 2, 1, get after it. You got it. One into the next. Come on, pushing yourself, guys. Nobody else can do it for you. It's all you, it's all mental. Just getting that much stronger with every rep. Focusing on what brought you here today to begin
with. Halfway point.
What is it? Why are you here? Trying to get stronger, lose weight. You got a sports team you're trying to make, whatever it is. Or you're just trying to kick butt at life. Putting in that work right here, come on.
2 more.
Almost there. Fight to the end.
Last one.
All right.
Ooh, I felt that 5-pound increase.
Yes, I felt my increase as well. We got one last set of these pop-ups. Let's go. Get after it, guys. You got it. You got it. In 3, 2, 1, begin. Come on. Here it is. Right here. Last set, guys. Never said this is going to be easy, but it will be worth it. If it were easy, everybody be fit, and it wouldn't be so special.
That's the halfway point.
But it's not easy. Not easy at all, but you're here, you're fighting. You're putting in the work, keep it up. Almost there.
Last one.
There it is. Ah, nice job.
All right, we have an upper body superset coming at you next. We're gonna go back and forth between a pulling exercise and a pushing exercise. First, we're gonna do a self-supported dumbbell row. Feet are staggered, pulling back on that elbow, one dumbbell at a time. 3 sets of 8. And then we're gonna do 3 sets of 8 of a pike pushup. But let's go ahead and get started on that self-supported row. I'm gonna go a little bit heavier on this one. If you have heavier weight, it's generally one that you can go a little bit heavier on. All right, so we're gonna do 8 repetitions. Feet are staggered, little bend in those knees. You can put that opposite hand behind your back. Back stays straight, bend over on a 45 degree angle. Pull them back in 3, 2, 1, let's hit it. For 8 repetitions, full range of motion. Breathe. Pulling back on that elbow. Nice, keep it up.
2 more.
Get that back and core straight.
Last one.
Perfect, all right, switching sides, opposite side now. You got it, again, core stays tight, and begin. On this one, we're trying not to use momentum. Want your whole body to just be stabilizing, not moving around or shaking.
2 more.
Working that core is engaged. Last one, boom, right there. Okay, so we can set the dumbbell down. We're moving into a pike push-up. I'm gonna do an elevated pike push-up, so I'm gonna actually use my bench, where Claudia's gonna do this one from the ground. They're both tough. This is very similar.
They really are.
Very similar to like a handstand movement. On this one, we're gonna have our fingers facing one another. We're gonna come up on one leg, and I want you to scoot up and look back at that back leg and that back foot. Now we're gonna drop straight down and come straight up for 8 repetitions, starting in 3, 2, 1, let's hit it. Trying your best to get full range of motion on this one. And if both of these moves are too tough for you today, you can just go ahead and do a traditional push-up and work your way up to this. You decide which variation is right for you.
2 more.
Keep coming back, you're gonna get better every time you repeat this routine.
Last one.
Nice. All right, coming up slow. Don't want you to pass out. All right, let's grab that one dumbbell for those self-supported rows. Make sure you're using your legs to help pick up that dumbbell. Feet are staggered. 8 repetitions in 3, 2, 1. Begin. Full range of motion. Back stays nice and straight on this one. Pull back from that elbow. Anytime we're doing a row, you're pulling back like you have a string attached to that elbow. Almost there.
Last one right here.
There it is. Nice. Again, nice and controlled on both the pull and the way down. Don't just let that dumbbell fly down.
If you're doing that, then your weight's too heavy.
And begin. Breathe. Nice and controlled. All about that time under tension. Getting stronger with every repetition. You can feel that strength coming.
2 more.
Almost there. Excellent.
Nice.
All right.
Work.
Set that dumbbell down. Back into those pike push-ups. While your back is resting, let's work those shoulders, triceps, chest. Into position. Fingers are facing one another. Up on one leg or two. You decide which is right for you. We're dropping straight down and begin. Full range of motion again. Anytime we're up in one of these positions like this, it's very easy to hold your breath. Make sure you are breathing. Focus on it. Breathing in, breathing out. You got it.
2 more.
Getting stronger every rep. Right here. Nice. Okay, we got 2 down. We got 1 to go of each one. Let's get it, tribe. Let's go, HASfit tribe. Where you at? Where you at? Right here. Getting stronger now. Getting stronger now. Here we are. Feet shoulder width apart. Back is on a 45. And let's begin. Pull back on that elbow. You got it. Core stays tight. No twist on this one. Just really emphasize keeping that core nice and tight.
2 more.
Back stays straight.
Last one.
Excellent.
Nice work.
All right, last 8 of these. Last 8. Let's get it. Let's get it and begin. You got it right here. Remember, you're only in competition with yourself. Just want to beat that you from yesterday. Getting a little bit better every day. Look in the mirror. That's your competition.
Last one, guys, right here.
Come on. Nice. All right, all done with these. Let's hit that last set of push-ups. You got it right here. Stay strong through this. It's all mental right now. It's all mental. It's not even physical. It'd be so easy to quit or hit that pause button, but you're stronger than that. You're pushing through. Let's go. Push through it. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. I want you to impress yourself today with how well you did. Here it is. Full range of motion all the way up, all the way down. Grind through it. Grind through it. You got it. Breathe.
2 more, guys.
Almost there. Last one. That's it. Nice work.
All right. So the next superset is going to be a superset between a squat plus a high pullback and either a leg raise or a knee raise plus a dumbbell chest press. So you're going to need both dumbbells for both of these exercises.
We're doing 3 sets of each of them.
At 8 apiece.
Feet are shoulder width apart. You're going to drop those weight back in your hips, doing a traditional squat. Dumbbells are to your side. And as you pull up, pull those dumbbells up, bring them up and pull back for 8 repetitions. Let's hit it in 3, 2, 1. You got it. Use that power from your legs to help propel those dumbbells up. And when they get to the top, boom, bring those elbows up and pull back. You
got it. So it's about chest level that we're pulling them up to.
Exactly. Keep that core tight. Back stays nice and straight on this one. Almost there.
You have 1 more, guys.
Last one. Good. Okay, we're going to take these dumbbells to the ground with you. We're going to lie down flat on our backs, legs out straight in front of us. We're going to do a chest press at the same time, either doing a leg raise or a knee raise. You decide which variation is right for you. Here we are in 3, 2, 1. Good. Nice full range of motion on this one.
Try not to rest your feet in between.
You got it. Nice and controlled. Breathe.
Halfway through this one.
Full range of motion on that press, but at the same time, not bouncing your arms up off the ground.
You guys, we have 1 more.
Last one right here. Excellent. All right, let's come back up. Time for some squat pullbacks. Feet are shoulder width apart. We're using those legs to generate power on this one. Here we are. 3, 2, 1. Weight back in the hips. Elbows come up. Pull back. You got it. 1 right into the next. Come on, you're a powerhouse. Power factor. You can't be stopped. Can't stop, won't stop. Right here. You got to fight into the end. You've come this far today.
2 more.
Now is not the time to quit.
Last one.
Boom, you got it. Okay.
Woohoo.
Back to the ground. We can tell this one's working. Don't forget, change doesn't happen without you being challenged. All right, legs are out straight to start. Keep the legs straight or bent. You decide. 3, 2, 1, and begin. Nice. This one's really working that anterior chest, shoulders, and your abs. Nice full range of motion. If you're having trouble with your lower back arching on this one, go ahead and bring your head up off the ground and make it a little more comfortable on that lower back.
2 more.
You got it, almost there. Last one. Excellent. Okay, 1 more of each, guys. That's it, just 1 more of each. Right here, right now.
I think I might increase my weight just a little bit.
All right, you choose a weight that's right for you. Customize this workout to your needs, guys.
Last set of these.
3, 2, 1, right into it. Right here, again. Think about what motivates you. What brought you here today to begin with? That's it. Focus on that why. Focus on that goal. Every rep, you're just getting that much closer. You got it. Breathe.
2 more.
Almost there. Use those legs. Weight back in your hips. Big power. Nice. Whew. Okay. Let's get this last set. Chest press plus leg or knee raise. You got it right here. And 3, 2, 1, 0. This is it right here. Stay focused. What motivates you? Everything you want, all your goals, all at the top of that staircase. Every workout, every rep, and just taking one more step closer to those goals up at the
top.
You
guys, we have 2 more.
Here it is, almost there. Last one, stay strong. Nice. I'm gonna set those dumbbells down and off to the side. We're gonna go through a quick little cool down. And the purpose of this cool down is, one, to allow your heart rate to come back down slowly, but then also to gain some extra mobility. So let's go ahead and lie down flat on our backs. We're gonna bring your right knee, legs are out straight. We're gonna bring your right knee into your chest the best you can. If you don't have full complete mobility on this one like we have, that's all right, do the best you can. Just breathe.
Ooh, nice big deep breaths in and out.
You successfully made it through this workout. You should be proud of yourself. All right, now let's take that knee and let's bring it over to your left side. Now, how far you take that knee over is gonna be totally dependent on your mobility and flexibility. Might just be a little bit, might be able to get it all the way to the ground, but try your best to keep your shoulders and upper body still flat on the ground. For 3, 2, 1, reverse. And let's do your left leg now. Bring that left knee into your chest. Excellent.
This one feels great on the lower back for sure.
Yes, it does. Lower back and hips getting stretched out on this one. We did a lot of lower back work today. You might be sore in your lower back, and that's okay. People always get a little scared when they're sore in their lower back, but it's not always a bad thing. Think about just the way you work your abs. No different to work your lower back. Now let's bring that knee over to your right side. Good. Trying your best to keep your upper body flat on the ground. Excellent. Pull that knee across. Feel that stretch. There it is. For 3, 2, 1, and 0. Good. Okay, now we can go ahead and have both feet flat on the ground. Your knees are up. We're going to do a little shoulder mobility drill next. Both arms are going to start straight up. Hands are together. And allow those arms to fall back over your head and come back forward. Try your best to keep your arms straight. So we're gonna really work that mobility in your shoulders. And you might not be able to quite get all the way down, be able to reach the ground, and that's okay. Just do the best you can. Or if this is too easy for you and you're not feeling a stretch, you can also use a myofascial ball or a tennis ball and place it in your upper back, and it'll make it just a little tougher. Nice, full range of motion. I find when I do this one, you know, my fifth or sixth reps feel a lot better than my first couple.
Definitely. That little twinge I had is gone.
And there it is. All right. Must be doing something right. Keep it up. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay, we're gonna come up now, nice and slowly. Don't want you passing out on me here. Onto one knee, we're gonna do a hip flexor and quad stretch next. So both knees are bent at a 90 degree angle. And your first step on this one is to squeeze your glutes and then squeeze your abs before you do anything else. Now with those squeezed, go ahead and come forward just ever so slightly. It doesn't take much. And you start to feel that stretch in your quad and in your hip flexor. And if you're not feeling it, it's probably because you don't have your abs and your glutes squeezed. So squeeze them good. Great one just to go ahead and stretch out that quad and that hip flexor. They get beat up so much in our everything from our workouts to just the hours we spend seated. 3, 2, 1. Good. All right, switch it up now. Opposite side. Again, squeeze those glutes, then squeeze your abs. Now come forward. A lot of times people do this move without squeezing the glutes and without squeezing the abs, and then come really far forward and get, you know, only a tenth of the stretch. As long as you keep them squeezed, it doesn't take much movement. Good posture. Again, just breathe. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Come on up. We got one last move here. We're gonna do a classic, a posterior shoulder stretch. Just grab that right arm, bring it across your body with your left hand, left arm, and feel that stretch in both your posterior, your shoulder, and your anterior. Pull it across the best you can and just hold. Keep good posture. This is it right here. It's always a classic move.
Yep.
I've been doing this one since PE, but hey, you know, sometimes it's a classic because it works, right?
Hey, exactly.
All right, holding this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it loose.
Why mess with a good thing?
That's it. Switch it up.
Make sure your shoulder is down, right? Not punched up this way.
Like down, down how?
Square.
Yeah, square with your body.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Have post-exercise brain.
I know,
where, you
me
know,
too. We're right there with you guys. We're here fighting with you. We thank you so much for working with us today. 3, 2, 1, 0. Shake it loose. You made it. You're done. High five out there. Thank you so much, HASfit Tribe, for working out with us today. If you like this workout and you've been working out with us for a while, starting to see some results, we'd encourage you to please go check out our Patreon page. We can find out more about how you can support our mission of keeping these great workouts free.
And if you enjoyed working out with us today, we ask that you please subscribe to this YouTube channel. That way you never miss another workout from HASfit.
Make sure to give this workout a big thumbs up and check out HASfit.com for hundreds of free workouts, free meal plans, and our free complete fitness programs.
If you are on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, find us on your favorite social media network. Connect with us because we want to connect with you.
Again, thank you so much. It's been our privilege to work out with you today. I'm Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia.
And we will see you at your next workout.